Hello everyone, and welcome to Not For Broadcast, given to me by NotGames. I've actually had this for quite a while, but I haven't been able to play it, unfortunately, due to technical issues. I've also been recently given one of the DLCs. So, without further ado, let's get into it.
That's all coming up on tonight's National Nightly News.
Also, I do apologize about the volume, I have turned it down. But it seems it still wants to be loud. Nice intro. Nice intro, but a bit loud. Peter Clement, a TV personality with a high popular DIY show, is one of the leaders of the Advanced Party. No idea what the advanced party is, but we shall see. Am I being controlled by a puppet? Please tell me that's not me. Day one, the election. Hello? Not Five Nights at Freddy's, are we? Hello? Turn right. Oh. Oh, hello,
hi,
person.
David, I have a call for you. I'm just putting
my name's not David, I'm Kata. This really does feel like Five Nights at Freddy's at the moment.
You're gonna have to run the news tonight. Now, don't worry, it's not hard, and I'm gonna stay on the phone and help you. First, I'm gonna give you a quick tour of the broadcast room, so if you're not doing it already, look forwards towards all those screens.
Okay.
Right, look up at the top. That coloured bar is your audience. You wanna keep the viewers going up and not down. Underneath that, you've got the screens.
Right.
On the right is the broadcast screen.
Okay.
That's what the viewers. That's the one you control. Now,
right.
The four small screens on the left.
Five screens for me.
Coming from the studio, and you can choose between them using the numbered buttons on the visual
okay.
mixer at the bottom left.
This sounds technical.
Don't worry. I'll talk you through it and you'll pick it up.
You better.
Now, have a look to your left. These plugs control everything in the studio. I've left them set up for you, so provided you haven't fiddled with them, all you have to do now is throw the master trip switch and we're in. Once you've got the power on, face the front again. You can see on the broadcast screen that we're in the end titles for the show before us.
Right.
Surely they go on for fucking ages, so there's plenty of time for me to explain. Oh, right, okay, they're over, so we haven't got long now till the broadcast.
That's your fault.
Hey, mate, look down under the desk. You can
okay.
see a load of videotapes on the left. They're your adverts. Pick any three and load them into the machines on the right.
Let's go with, Crazy Neil, My Salad Week, My Salad Weekly, whatever that is, and Come to Bumbly. That sounds really weird.
Right, won't be long now till the signal starts coming through from the station.
Who named those videos? I want to know that. Yeah, sure, we'll try.
When you get the signal, select screen one with the vision mixer and we're ready to go.
There we go.
Yeah, I thought it might increase our viewing figures.
Every day. You offer me prawns every day.
10 seconds, everybody. How I show love.
Your prawns are nice.
And yet you persist. Going in 5, 4. It's time to
join Jeremy Donaldson. Good evening. I'm Jeremy Donaldson. Our main story is tonight.
Huh, that's really cool.
Good. Next is going to be the throw to the news titles on screen 2. There'll be a countdown, but I'll count you in as well. Just relax, mate. It's all gravy.
Okay.
Andy's totally independent and corners the flawed market. Top chat. Sports fans everywhere celebrate as popular footballer.
How do I
win sports person?
Oh god, I feel like I'm working here now. It's really creepy.
Megan
going up.
Lawrence Bunderclatch about his new movie, The Medicated. And of course,
we'll be going live to
headquarters to hear what the leaders of this fledgling party have to say on their historic.
Right. Two, one, lovely mate.
I like that I can actually use the numbers on my keyboard as well.
When that globe in the middle shrinks down and vanishes.
Nice intro. I actually really like this. think I did it a little early, maybe. The landslide victory, with an astonishing 81% of the popular vote, is the biggest election win in living memory. God, you have to multitask on this one like crazy. Up and down the country with their bold promises of permanent change. But critics have accused him of a severe lack of actual policy and of being deliberately vague. I like the actors for this. It's really well done. He does no games. Seriously. However, former Home Secretary...
It's going well. All you've got to do now is play the advert at the end of the segment. Make sure you don't play it too early or we'll all get fired.
I can't play it now and get fired. Can you down to the advert? When it reaches zero, press one of the three play ad buttons over there at the I can do that. That makes perfect sense, actually. A, B, C.
And 3, 2, 1, advert.
1 minute back.
Play the fucking ad, mate.
I need you to fill out the ads.
What? Why?
Wanker Snatch is running late.
Damn, it didn't work how I was meant to. I thought if I pressed a letter, it'd be right.
That's the same policy we use with you. I thought that was our little secret. That's all right, he doesn't remember anything I tell him.
I'm deeply uncomfortable with your burgeoning friendship.
Crazy Neil.
The first ad break. You're doing great, mate. But this is where it starts getting a bit trickier. This next sequence is what we call a multi-camera sequence, because you're going to be cutting between multiple cameras to keep things interesting. A lot of it's down to personal taste, but here's three good rules of thumb.
Right.
One, try and keep the shot on whoever is doing the talking. Two, don't stay on the same shot for too long.
Oh, jeez.
If you're on the person who's
okay.
Talking, okay. Just to keep it interesting. Three, don't stay on reaction shots for too long. A couple of seconds is usually enough. Then the audience will see.
There's so much going on, but I really love this.
It's not as complicated as it's.
I'm sorry I've been so quiet, guys. There's so much going on right now.
Make it look like those. Might as well get screen one selected.
Whoever's on screen three, he's having fun right now. I guess I'll go to screen one.
Later we'll be hearing from shock election winners advance. But first,
get ready to go to Megan on screen four.
Roger Dodger.
Here are the star of both stage and screen. Megan?
Thank you, Jeremy. Megan Wolf, culture correspondent. And today I have a guest who starred in everything from Shakespeare.
Right,
to the
go to Blunderclatch on screen three when she says his name.
By none other than Lawrence Blunderclatch. Thank you so much for coming on.
Oh, my dear, I do hope you believe me when I tell you that being with you here today is a moment.
Switch to two for the wide now.
May I say, having you here with us is among ours.
Right, now just try and stay on whoever's talking.
Movie, which is called The Medicated.
The Medicated?
Wow, what was that like?
Well, as I said to Peter at the Rat, that's Peter Jensen, the director.
Give us a look at Megan's reaction.
He's a wonderful chap.
Lovely, now back to Thunder Twat.
I worked with him on several movies, all terribly successful. I said to Peter, what a wild ride this has been. And you know what, Megan? I really meant that.
That is fantastic. And am I right in saying that the character you play in this movie is quite an academic one?
Absolutely right. A scientist. Absolutely
was that right. A challenge at all?
What exactly are you implying? But seriously, yes, you're right. It was a complete departure from my last starring role when I played Sergeant Brock Rockman in Bullet Man. You'll remember that that was the true story of one soldier's fight for a love that surpasses all others. A love, of course. For freedom. Love, of course. I think it's grossed over $1 billion, but
I don't know if I'm doing this right, but I think I'm doing it right.
That's where you scoop two best actor awards, if I remember correctly.
It's so sweet of you to mention it, but I really am not in it for the awards, although those three little statues do take pride of place on my mantelpiece.
With all the others, I'm sure. So, if you're not doing it for the awards, what is it then that drives you?
I really want to know how they came up with this. It's so good. It's really well done.
Like you, I'm afraid. Cut me, and I will bleed. And often,
that's how it feels, doesn't it? Bleeding, giving, suffering
for one's audience. I suppose in the end, I do it for the difference it makes. I do it for the people that I inspire, the little people. But most of all, I think I do it for the positive change that I can bring about in the world.
And today, of course, we're in for some real change, it looks like, in the coming few months. What do you make of this historic election result?
Oh, well.
It's very weird here in Double as well right now. I'm sure there's a way to change that a little. But I have a funny feeling if I change the audio, it's going to mess up the actual live broadcast.
Been quite clear that when it comes to politics, that one should always strive to not fuck things up.
Jeez. Oh, don't worry, you won't do it again. She did it again. Okay, don't panic. I'll explain how to deal with swearing at the break.
Medicated, which opens next week.
Right, they've swapped the shot of Jeremy on screen one for a VT of the movie clip. You'll get a countdown on the screen, but I'll just let Megan cue you in.
My character, Dr. Lance Hemlock, is faced with a decision that could affect humanity's very survival.
Exciting stuff. Let's take a look. Exciting stuff.
Cool, looks like Blunderclatch is really losing it in the studio. I'd love to hear what he's saying, but we can't find out now. We'll go to the Rush's room together once the broadcast's over.
Poor Megan. That is such a poorly made movie.
It's not your fault.
You think I don't know that?
Condolences, we mustn't.
You threw yourself at him! He didn't do it! That's such bad acting. It's funny though. Is it meant to be a comedy?
I didn't listen.
Doctor.
I'm drowning, Lance, you said.
You need to see this.
No, it's all too late.
This is so good. I really, really like this. I'd love this if this was my actual job. Oh, God, I love this so much.
The sterility. This formula, this is the key.
We could stop it all.
Yes, we could stop it all. We have to ask ourselves.
This is such a boring movie trailer.
You'll want to play another ad.
Yep.
Remember to use the clock at the top to count you in.
Right, I've got about 10 minutes. Yep. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Right, I guess I better explain how to deal with bleeping out swear words. As you've probably noticed, the broadcast screen here is about 2 seconds behind the master screen.
Okay. Right.
2 seconds later, you'll hear that swear word go.
Right, okay, that makes sense.
And you need to hold down the bleep button or the space bar on your keyboard for as long as the swear word lasts. It can take a bit of practice getting used to hearing two things at once. Just stay calm and you'll get it.
I can try.
And if you can't tell when to bleep, just above the button, you'll literally be able to see the sound scrolling by. All you gotta do is hold it down while the red bit is over the red line.
Right.
Most people like to have the volume of the broadcast screen a little bit below the master screen. Let's set it now.